welcome to Now Showing. I'm Atika Farooqui. Today, as you can see, it is a colourful show. Different hues that make up our lovely film industry. Shamshera is out at the box office. Team Ek Villain is back with a bang. A national award-winning director on a film that changed his life forever. And a music director whose songs you can give your all to sing to. The secret of getting ahead in life is in getting started. So, let's get started with the headlines. Shamshera is a spectacular visual experience with strong performances by Ranbir Kapoor and Sanjay Dutt. An evening with the team of Ek Villain that vows to storm the box office again. Udta Punjab director Abhishek Chaubey talks about the film that changed his life. And music composer Mithoon talks about composing music for Shamshera. To begin with, let's talk about Shamshera that releases at the box office this week. Directed by Agnipath famed director Karan Malhotra, starring Ranbir Kapoor, Vani Kapoor and Sanjay Dutt, this period saga is a story of dacoits.
Set in the 1800s, the story follows a dacoit tribe and their fight for independence against the British rule.
The film grabs your attention from the first frame itself. Ranbir Kapoor delivers a mesmerizing performance in a double role. So does film's villain, Sanjay Dutt.
A lower caste tribe called Khamirans helped the Rajputs against a historical battle and then found a place called Kaza to settle down. The leader Shamshera, played by Ranbir Kapoor, is conned by the British into finding a place that they can call their own and is killed by the British in a sly trap that they are historically famous for. The Khamirans were doomed into slavery until Shamshera's son must find Azadi for them. Ranbir Kapoor gets a role to shine in. He shows his acting prowess, pathos in expressions, kalaripayattu and other martial art forms in action scenes and humour. It's a role tailor-made for him as it required a lot of heavy weight lifting in terms of performance. Ranbir steals the show with the variety of expressions and a diaspora of looks and impact. It's a Ranbir Kapoor show all the way. Sanjay Dutt in the role of Shuddh Singh is a hysterically laughing villain here who's bloodthirsty and does not bat an eyelid before mercilessly beating up the Khamirans. He calls them Kira, Makora, dirt, filth, the anger and vengeance of which is unknown and unexplained, given that he himself is Indian. His arch nemesis, though, in the form of Bali, played by Ranbir, is calm and confident.
Featuring elaborate set pieces, immersive camera work and melody tunes of Mithoon, especially the song Fitur. I was quite absorbed in the picturesque visuals shot by cinematographer Anay Goswami.
The film is made for the big screen and often gives a feeling of competing with SS Rajamouli cinema. It's a brave attempt as the film does take a leap in terms of scale and shot taking. If the reports of 150 crores as an investment into the film is true, then it surely shows. The scenes with Vani Kapoor are more glamorous than authentic as the modern clothes and the associated scenes take away from the 19th century palette of the treatment. The film shines in the climax as one of the most ambitious train robbery scenes is attempted, reminding us of Dhoom experience.
It's a film that's soothing for the eyes and also is lofty in its scale. The ones who love a big screen experience with melodrama and some great action, this one is meant for you. However, there were underwhelming scenes that prevented the film from becoming more wholesome and logical. Moving on, Ek Villain released in 2014, which had Siddharth Malhotra, Shraddha Kapoor and Ritesh Deshmukh in the lead roles. The film told the story about a young woman who got murdered by a serial killer and how later her husband tries to take revenge on the killer. The film is an official remake of I Saw the Devil. Now, director Mohit Suri comes back with Ek Villain Returns with Arjun Kapoor, Tara Sutaria, John Abraham and Disha Patani in the lead roles. In conversation with them, it's me. So, Ek Villain returns or Ek Villain ke saath saath, he also returns. Now, I don't know who is he. Either it has to be John Abraham or Arjun Kapoor. So, who's the villain?
The most interesting part about this film is that you have said that Arjun or John is this film's special thing. Tara and Disha can also be. And that's what the intrigue is. If you see the trailer, if you notice, the answers to the questions that normally would come through in a trailer, we've not given. So we've not made you choose a side. So even in the first one, there was a little bit of clarity about kaun kya hai.
Haan, pata tha.
इस फिल्म में आप ट्रेलर देखे तो ये नहीं बता सकते कि कौन विलन है बिकॉज़ हम चारों ही विलन हैं
एंड यू नो अर्जुन आल्सो बिफोर टर्निंग इनटू एन एक्टर यू आर एन एडी फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम एंड दैट वुड हैव आल्सो गिवन यू अ स्किल सेट दैट मेड यू अंडरस्टैंड अ लॉट अबाउट प्रोडक्शन डायरेक्शन एंड परफॉर्मेंसेस एंड योर व्यू ऑफ एक्टर्स
या माय फर्स्ट फिल्म आई हैड द प्लेजर ऑफ सीइंग शाहरुख खान एंड सैफ अली खान एंड प्रीति जिंटा एंड जया बच्चन सो आई वाज ऑन कलोना सेट एंड एंड यू वैल्यू द हार्ड वर्क दैट गोज इन टू मेक अ फिल्म टिल यू आर नॉट ऑन अ सेट आपको कहीं ना कहीं वो पता नहीं लगता कि मेहनत का काम है भाई
सही बात है
इवन दो आई एम फ्रॉम द इंडस्ट्री यू नो यू कम इन एज अ चाइल्ड ऑन योर फादर्स साइड यू आर पैम्पर्ड एंड टेकन केयर ऑफ इट्स वेरी डिफरेंट यू आर चाइल्ड आई वाज अ टेरिबल असिस्टेंट ऑन कलोना इफ आई मे से सो
एंड आई टेरिबल
आई वाज वेरी यंग एंड आई वाज 16 17
ओके
तो मैं अच्छा असिस्टेंट नहीं था ज्यादा एंड I don't deny that at all. I've been caught sleeping and all on set also. So, but फिर भी सीखने का मौका जरूर मिला. एक्टर को देखने का मौका मिला. क्लैप देता था. मेकिंग करता था फिल्म की उस समय. So you're very right about the fact that you understand the facets of filmmaking. And I think an actor today, when you're making films, I'm not saying you need to be aware of everything. But you need to be aware that there is a lot going on to make sure that you can give this shot. So that for me was a big learning when I was growing up that yes, hard work is very important in this profession. Important. Contrary to what you feel from outside.
Of course. But you know, you are directly related to several people in the industry in a way that you
too many people I feel sometimes.
Too many, exactly. You assisted
Ji.
The director in Kalhona Ho. Yeah. You saw Shah Rukh Khan very closely.
Yes.
You assisted Saif Ali Khan very closely. I mean,
as an assistant.
And then you worked with Saif. Your father has been one of those producers who've seen everything in the under the sun in the film industry. If the viewers watching you want to know several things about the film industry that they must learn via the experiences of these people,
every film and every person teaches you. I think I've been lucky, but if you're asking me about these three people, I think from my father, the one thing that I have learned is the decency you need to have as a person regardless of success and failure. He's seen lots of ups and downs and he's always been a selfless person. And in this profession, you need to also be there for others. So I think that's something I learned from dad. Shah Rukh Khan se kya nahi seekh sakta aadmi, har roz kuch seekh le yaar. But jis tarah wo aurton ki izzat karte hai, I think off camera ho. Jis tarah wo aurton ko romance karte hai, shayad isiliye kar paate hai because wo genuinely unko value karte
hai.
And I'm sure you've interacted with him. When Shah Rukh Khan speaks to you, he's talking to you.
Yeah, 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 totally.
The way he engages with you. And Shah Rukh Khan is blessed with oratory skills. You know, jis tarah wo baat karte hain. Aur ek apnapan mehsoos karate hain. Aapki aankhon ke andar jhaak ke dekh sakte hain. Aaj bhi main unke ghar kabhi jata hoon, toh wo bahar tak aake darwaza khol ke mujhe gaadi mein bithate hain. And I'm saying women specifically because I think that's very important for young people to know that man is one of the biggest stars this world will ever see. But just the fact that he has that understanding of how to be different with a man and a woman shows his upbringing, his culture, his thought process. And if you can imbibe on camera, then you can learn sekhlo. Lekin off camera, agar Shah Rukh Khan se kuch seekhna hai, to bas wahi seekho ki kis tarah wo auraton ke saath bartav karte hain. And that is why he's the most charming man in the world. Saif, he's a child. He's a mad genius.
He's a man child.
Yeah. He's got eccentricities in him as an actor, which come from a place of him also as a person having that. Very feisty actor to work with because you can never predict what he'll do and that's amazing. On camera ho ya off camera, the one thing that I love about Saif is he's seen so much failure, you know.
So much failure, yeah.
And
right.
He's not bothered by it. He's moved into that stage in life, or perhaps he's achieved so much in life despite the failures that he's fought back every time and he knows he's got that inner confidence and he's got that inner ease. There's a personal style.
True.
He's never imitated anybody. Yeah. You know, people who made fun of his voice and all today love his voice.
Totally.
People who thought he looked so different today, he's one of the most good-looking men.
Yes.
So Saif Ali Khan has remained himself enigmatic in a way.
True.
And he's attracted on the merit of his talent versus trying to go out there and do PR or try to position himself or posture. So that's a 25-30-year career now. It's amazing. And that's something I would love to also replicate. You shouldn't chase.
You should
just have that aura that people come towards you for the work that you do and the way you are as a person.
I don't ask personal questions, but congratulations on a beautiful professional life that
you're
personal life that you're enjoying.
Thank you.
And I hope to see you in a lot of good projects
Thank you.
That back your talent, that back your ambition and your view of your future.
Thank you so much.
Thanks. Up next, we have the national award-winning director of Udta Punjab, Ishqiya, Shamshera and Ray, Abhishek Chaubey, talking to my colleague Vishal Chatkara about the film that changed his life. It's the film that he watched while studying at Delhi University and had left a big impression on his mind and his cinema. Listen in.
Film that changed my life, I would say, would be François Truffaut's 400 Blows. I was all of 18 and I was in college in Delhi, and I had only seen Hindi movies and a few English movies up until that point in time, and I had made a new set of friends. We became members of the French Film Society, and there was a retrospective of François Truffaut films being screened there, and we took a bus to the French Center and we were put in a theater, small little room where they projected the film. That was the first time I saw a film and I realized that films can go beyond entertainment, that they can move you in certain ways that you did not expect cinema to move you. And I was simply blown by it. And I would say that's where my cinematic journey really began, because it's, you know, and I remember I came out of the film and could not stop talking about it all the way, walking those 15 kilometers back home.
Okay.
400 Blows is a story of Antoine Doinel. He's this adolescent child in 1950s France, and he's a bit of a rebel. He lives with his mother and his stepfather, and he loves them, but has a difficult relationship with them. Has a tremendously difficult relationship with his school teacher.
Vous êtes un abominable plagiaire.
C'est pas vrai, monsieur.
Allez immédiatement porter votre copie à monsieur le directeur.
You know, he's considered a sort of a delinquent, you know, although we know him. And he's a misunderstood child. And it's his story, it's his journey, how he, you know, what happens to him. Finally, he's put in a jail for kids, and how he runs away from there. And the iconic last shot of the film where he looks into the lens and it freezes frame.
Que votre ami Doinel ait cru devoir choisir pour sujet la mort de son aïeul, c'était son droit.
You really connect with the child in the film. You really empathize with him, and you really understand him, and you really see the world from his point of view. And you realize something about not only that child, but you understand something about French society also at that point in time. It's a terrific piece, and it's very moving for sure.
Il faut juste 1000 francs, pas seulement.
Si tu me demandes 1000 francs, c'est que t'en espères 500, donc t'as besoin de 300. Tiens, voilà 100 balles. Tiens, voilà 520.
Oh, merci.
Mais en principe, c'est ta mère qui paie ça.
There's a wonderful prophetic line in the film where the school teacher says, what's going to happen to France 10 years from now, looking at this generation, looking at these school kids who are creating a ruckus in the class. And this was 1958. And 10 years later, there was the student movement in France, and he was talking about that generation which went ahead and did started a revolution in Europe.
Ah, elle va être un peu belle, la France, dans 10 ans.
It helped me understand human relationships better, but with regards to cinema and how do you portray relationships in movies, you know?
J'ai eu ton âge, moi aussi. Vous oubliez toujours ça, les gosses. Moi aussi, j'étais butée. Je ne voulais rien confier à mes parents. Je préférais tout écrire dans un journal.
There's one particular wonderful scene where Antoine is talking to a psychiatrist, and the camera is on Antoine, you know, it never cuts to the psychiatrist, and the questions are being asked and he is talking, you know, and it was a lot of apparently, this is what I've read, it was all improvisation that Jean-Pierre did, and that brusque attitude that early bully in Udta Punjab has is perhaps borrowed from there, although subconsciously.
Tes parents disent que tu mens tout le temps.
Je mens de temps en temps, quoi. Des fois, je leur dirai des choses qui seraient la vérité, ils ne me croiraient pas, alors je préfère dire des mensonges.
This is the film that taught me what you could do with a camera, what you could do with characterizations, how much can you push the limits, how you can use images as symbols to narrate, you know, tell the condition, human condition. It's relevant today because all kids are naughty, and they're supposed to be naughty, but they're not supposed to be punished for it, you know. And absolutely relevant today in any part of the world, including ours.
Time for a short break on the show. When we come back, we have music man Mithoon talking about his favorite tunes. You remember that song? Mola mere, mola mere, mola mere, mola. Loved it. So, a chat with him after the break. Welcome back to Now Showing. I am Atika Farooqui. Music composer Mithoon, who has created chart busters such as Mola Mere Mola from the film Anwar, Kyunki Tum Hi Ho from Aashiqui 2 and Tujhe Kitna Chahne Lage from Kabir Singh, actually comes from a family of musicians. His father, Naresh Sharma, is Hindi cinema's one of the most successful music arrangers and also the younger brother to Pyare Lal of Lakshmikant Pyare Lal fame. My colleague Vishal Chatkara caught up with Mithoon earlier this week and got him talking about composing music for this week's big release, Shamshera, casting voices and the pros and cons about new voices that are being discovered on the social media platforms these days.
Mithoon, your latest offering, Shamshera's music, is out and it got a big thumbs up from the audience. You have not just composed the music but also written most of the songs. Yeah. Does that make the journey for a composer special when you are so closely involved with the whole music process?
I think my perspective is, Vishal, ki being a music composer, you have to be closely involved in the process. Even if I'm not writing a song, if I'm working with a writer, it's very important for me to go to the core of the emotion, the core of the expression, and understand what the film needs, what the director wants, and what needs to be done, right from the poetry to the melody to the orchestration, the arrangement. We'll speak about it more in detail. But I think answering your question, that it's not necessary that if I'm writing, I have to be more closely involved. In fact, many a times I come up with a basic thought for a song as the basic idea. And then I share it with the poet. And then he obviously takes it a few notches higher. But understanding the core of a song is my job under any circumstance.
You know, you are somebody who always been experimenting with the voices. How do you decide which song would be suitable for which singer?
There are parameters called, there's something called as range. There is something called as register. There is something called as grain, tonality. There are various things. Every singer has his own ground from where he operates. What kind of pronunciation are we looking at? What kind of aura do we want to create? And then obviously we cast the right singer for the song.
You know, you're somebody who's very passionate about music, and you, because you write your own songs, sometimes even sing them. How do you know when a song is ready?
I think it's a feeling, Vishal. It's a very good question. When my director briefs me or when I want to write about something, I obviously take my time. I pray, I seek, I search. I spend time on an instrument, on my piano, or I write something. But when I get a feeling like, you know, that this sounds complete, I still remember it was one quiet afternoon. Mohit Suri had just left after briefing me for Aashiqui 2. And after the discussion, I just remember I was on the piano and the first melody that came to me, what I played was.
What do you feel about this new trend of artists coming up from social media platform? Like, we have seen singers breaking out, doing a single on YouTube or on Instagram.
I think there are pros and cons to it. On one side, I would definitely encourage it because, you know, there is a lot more platform available now for artists to break through and for their music to reach people. And that's why we've got so many independent artists also in the last few years who are doing so well. But the other side of it is that sometimes it encourages a lot of mediocrity as well.
Dr. Siu said, don't cry because it's over. Smile because it happened. Let's not feel sad when a good thing comes to an end. Just the way you and I should not feel that this show ends here, but we think of the time when we meet again. Because good things deserve a rerun. We will meet again soon. Don't forget to watch Now Showing on Saturdays and Sundays. These are certainly the two best days of the week, aren't they? You take good care of yourself. I'm Atika Farooqui signing off. Till we meet again. Ta-da!